What do I look like right now? Yeah, that douchebag.
That's a cool dude, bro.
By douchebag, I mean
not YOLO douchebag.
Andy, who happens to look exactly like YOLO douchebag. If you don't know who YOLO douchebag, here's a picture of Andy and YOLO douchebag hanging out together at Texas 2K because they
like
did
Andy
meet.
Without hair.
Yeah. No, y'all have the same y'all have the same hairline and everything.
We had two cul-de-sacs. But he has one big one actually.
Yeah, Andy and YOLO douchebag look exactly alike. They act alike and everything. It's kind of funny. I've been sick, so we haven't posted any videos, but I'm starting to feel better and we have to get this motor on the road.
I already posted it on Instagram.
Andy finally took his motor out of the rat rod. It only took him 2 weeks to do it.
It's so hard.
But didn't even separate the transmission. So I swear to God, nothing ever gets done unless I come over and do it because he's worthless when it comes to doing things. I have to baby him for some reason. I don't know why that is.
How do you like that Exner Racing transmission?
Actually, that sounds pretty cool.
Yeah.
He kind of never answers my phone call, which I wouldn't either too, if I was calling.
Yeah, I've heard that once you get on someone's phone,
it's that
it's the relationship's pretty much over.
Because they like me, who I am, but they don't really know the real me.
No, they don't. The real Andy calls you nonstop 24/7, texts you all the time, and never leaves you alone. Ask me how I know. That's because he does it to me every single day of my freaking life.
Sometimes he never answers a damn phone.
Sometimes I just send him on voicemail just to piss him off. Just
I'm on the phone. What's up? And he's fucking watching a video.
He never lets me watch my videos.
It's like it's like me knowing that you're watching a video and be like, time to call one.
Alright. Hey, I got something for you today.
What'd you get?
Let me go get this box for you.
That's it? Oh, my fuel stuff. Freaking jerk. What is this?
Somehow in between the years of knowing Andy, we've actually known each other for what, like a whole year, right?
Yeah. No, it's been longer than a year. What's wrong with you? We started our
like
love
six
like
months? Love
5 years ago.
I don't know if I call it love, but
you were driving a sexy yellow Corvette and I thought you were the biggest douchebag ever.
Why?
You can ask Hayden.
Why?
Because I was like, I don't like Juan. It's fucking him and his yellow Corvette.
You just didn't like me because I owned a Corvette?
Well, because what the hell is this?
It's a spring, don't lose it. So I'm just gonna let you know now that there was a fee for me ordering their parts. And
I knew you had bought something.
I gotta take advantage of the free shipping.
Oh my god, dude, look at these things. Hashtag Summit. Looks good. Cheapest stuff out there.
It really is. I filled my whole car on Summit. I feel like I'm watching my kid Christmas morning opening his presents that he got from Santa.
What'd you get, baby boy?
A hose!
Can you open it like a civilized human?
I already have.
Yeah, we're gonna use your feed as your return.
Yes, there you go. Which is my return.
Yeah.
Honestly. Wow. But this is just fuel, right?
Yeah, this is just
fuel.
Towards the end of the rat rod's life, it started leaking coolant from the radiator. And then I guess he thought it'd be a smart idea to put some radiator repair shit in it. And this thing is full of gunk. That's so nasty.
Dude, I never put it in there.
I'm telling you, you put it in there. That's what that stuff is. What else would it be?
Here, go up a little bit with the bouncer.
Ugh.
Yes. Can you put the stupid camera down?
No. Some things are more important, you know.
Go up a little bit. Right there. I can't wait until American Speed Chef does the sauce for this thing. I just want to hear it run. I really don't care how fast it goes.
Because it's not going to be that fast. It's actually going
to Oh my god! What the fuck?
I put those converter bolts on.
It's actually going to be really... Do you think you're prepared for how fast this thing's going to be?
I don't know, but you're not the first person that tells me that.
Like, it's a whole other level.
Brandon from Bare Metal Speed Shop said, you're probably going to have to wear a Depend on the first couple passes. He's like, if I was you, I would run it on gates.
Just on. No, we're definitely gonna start you off on gate.
He's like, you literally need to graduate your way up.
I think the springs that are on those are like 6 or 8 pounds.
Which is about 800 pounds, 800 horsepower.
I don't know. And then we're gonna work you up from there. Just keep adding boost.
Did you cut that bolt down for it to fit?
Yeah, remember we cut it down because of the firewall.
There's like 2 threads in there only.
That's so bad.
Hey, we still went 902, guys. And it has a different size bolt on this. Oh my god, that's hilarious.
Is that your pile of bolts over there? Are you gonna remember where everything goes?
Dude, I've taken apart this truck so many times.
You know what the funny thing is? That on my car too, I'm like, I'll take all the bolts off and I'll, like, I know where this one bolt goes. You're like,
it's that special bolt.
I know this bolt.
You cost me a lot of headaches. I'll never forget you. That's Andy's wires right there.
Can you get a new trans brake solenoid?
Huh?
Can you get a new trans brake solenoid?
Dude, that thing works good.
No, this thing is all fucked up, man. That's the one you twisted all off, remember?
Well, I broke the one and then Extern felt sorry for me and gave me a used one.
Can you get a new one, please?
Can you order it?
Like $30.
Can you order it?
I'll order you one, Jesus.
This is gonna be too heavy.
It's a power glide. Those things don't weigh anything.
Juan, I don't do this stuff.
What do you mean? You're a body man.
This thing is too heavy.
Get all that black fluid coming
out. Dude, I'm telling you, dude. I don't know where that came from.
That is disgusting.
My wife's like, what did you put in your motor?
Radiator repair.
I want to be grounded up and put it into my engine when I die. I think my engine can handle this thickness with multiple Cs.
Time to go fast now.
Is it?
I think it's, you got a lot of work ahead of you, bro. Your car looks like mine right now.
Seriously, dude. Both of our cars are fucking down.
This and we got like 1 month left till Texas ticket.
Like 5 weeks, dude.
We're in trouble.
How many do we have?
It's February almost already.
It's basically February, so all of February. It's what, the second week of March?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
Anyways. Yeah, that's pretty much it for today. Not a whole lot going on. Like I said, it's been hard to get some videos out because, man, we're just waiting on money, we're waiting on parts, not a whole lot of stuff going on right now. And with the us delaying the delivery of the motor so that Hunter at American Speed Shops can get them rebuilt.
Which he's already confirmed added. That he likes my truck way more than
I'm
yours.
Sure.
And that's the reason why he's helping us out.
Yeah, I'm sure. We're gonna get back to it. We're gonna get back to the racing and everything once we get these cars back together.
What about your podcast that you told everybody you're going to start?
Sure. I'm not even going to get into that because of this guy, but we are going to do the podcast.
Live!
we are going to do the podcast. It's just eventual. It's just going to take a little bit of time.
Well, tell them the truth. Tell them the truth.
I'm trying to get everything set up.
Well, no. Tell them the reason why we can't do it. Just so we won't be misguiding people.
That's the real reason. Because you can't seem to come over ever.
Well, first of all, because I don't have Wi-Fi, is one.
Wi-Fi.
I'm moving.
He calls Wi-Fi Wi-Fi. I don't know why.
I'm moving houses.
Yes, you're moving.
So tell you.
So that's the reason why you can't come over? Is because you're moving?
No. Oh, because I thought we were going to do it here. But no, I can come to your house.
We were going to do it here because I can't ever get you to come over.
I'll leave it to you guys. If you guys say, let's do the podcast, and I want to see the review saying that you want to see me and hear me there, then I'll make it happen. If you guys say that you want Juan only, then I'm not ever going to be on the show.
Oh, you're going to be on the show, all right.
And it's like freaking just like, cold.
Just like you opt to be in these videos. It's not a choice.
A friend of mine asked me if he could record me, you know, bringing me some parts because he really did help me out. And I literally told him I am just way too busy like to do anything because I started a wheel business and it's just taking so much of my time. And he asked me, how does Juan get so many videos of you? I was like, he's a freaking paparazzi. He like literally sits outside my house. So I get out of him and he's like running with the camera as soon as I get out of him. I'm like, leave me alone. And he just doesn't leave me alone. I'm so sick and tired of him.
That's factual.
I'm gonna call the cops on him.
Anyways, that's it for now. We got something done, but we got a lot more
work. Hey, shout out to Slow Mock Racing for helping me out in those parts. I really do appreciate you helping me out, homie.
One big thumbs up.
Big thumbs up.
So that's it. We're gonna get going and what, Andy?
Oh, sorry.
Did a catchphrase at the end.
No, we're not in a podcast.
No, not that catchphrase. My catchphrase at the end of the
day. Let's get to work.